across the purple sky. All the birds are leaving, but how can they know it's time for them to go? Before the winter fire, I will still be dreaming. I have no thought of time. For who knows where the time goes? Who knows where the time goes? Deserted shore, your fickle friends are leaving. Ah, but then you know it's time for them to go. But I will still be here. I have no thought of leaving. I do not count the time. For who knows where the time goes? Who knows where the time alone, while my love is near me. I know it will be so until it's time to go. So come the storms of winter, and then the birds in spring again. I do not fear the time. For who knows how my love grows? Who knows where the time goes?
So have you actually, I assume you must have spoken to Carla in person, and you're finding her a lovely person, you say?
We sort of got in touch with each other around early 2021. I saw a post that she posted on Facebook of a cover of one of my mum's songs, and I was just blown away by it. It was so good. It's rare to hear someone cover one of my mum's songs and actually almost sound like her. Mm. And I wanted to hear more. And then the next thing I know, she's writing to me on Facebook. And, of course, I'm writing back. We got chatting, and she kept on posting her songs of Sandy. The songs of Sandy Denny on YouTube. You can check that out. Carla Fuchs, songs of Sandy Denny. She's got quite a few there. And we just started talking. We had heaps in common. And the more I heard her covers and her music, the more things sort of were ticking around in my head. And I know, I know that I wanted to do something more with my mum's stuff, and I wasn't sure what. And when I heard Carla singing, I just went, "That's it. I want her to finish my mum's unfinished work."
I'm wondering in what time frame these lyrics were found that your mum wrote but never put to music. Were they found before you got in touch with Carla and you thought she'd be the good one to do it, or was it after that?
Okay, so a singer-songwriter called Thea Gilmore had already done this through the estate, and she did it with the band, and it was a really good album. I just didn't hear my mum's essence in it, and I wasn't part of it then. And I just thought that this would be something I could do, and Carla had a real passion for my mum, and I just really liked the way she presented herself and the way she, her style, and I just thought that that would be a good idea. And we've had, so we have got all the lost lyrics. We're calling them the lost lyrics because, yeah. I asked Elizabeth Hurt, my stepmother and partner in the estate, whether she'd heard of Carla, and I sent her a link and I said, "Look, I want to do something with this girl. She's from Germany. She's a German singer-songwriter, music teacher, musicologist. Just total, like, she's just so brilliant. Like, I actually couldn't believe what she can do." So I said to Liz, "I would love to do something with her and have a listen." And she got back to me and said that that was a really good idea. And so I approached Carla and asked her if she wanted to do it. And she sort of nearly fell off a chair. She goes, "Really, are you serious? You want me to do this?" And I'm like, "Yeah, of course I do. Like, you're amazing." And we've become quite, like, I don't know, we've become very, very close. We're like sisters now. But we have never met each other. We've just had this bond.
How good is that?
Forming. Oh, it's amazing. And we're going to see each other in a month, and it's going to be, I don't know what's going to happen. I think we'll probably do a lot of crying and, you know, a lot of hugging. And, yeah, she's just, she's my soul sister. We've really become really close over this whole project. We didn't know what we were going to call the project. We didn't know. It was sort of like a blueprint thing, or we weren't sure what to call it. And Carla had written this song called Songbird. Mm-hmm. And it was dedicated to me and Sandy. And it is the most beautiful song. And I just went, the album's going to be called Songbird. That's it. It's Songbird. So that's the feature song, and it's by Carla. It's all Carla, that song. And the album's called Songbird because it represents my mum.
It kind of works in every way, doesn't it?
Yeah, yeah. And in one of the diaries that she's got, there's a little bird that she's sketched, and that is the album cover. Yeah, it's been 6 months of late nights. And across three, you know, like, time zones, we've got Sean Phillips in Oxford, UK, helping me with all the design of the album, and Carla in Germany, and us in Australia, and my stepmom in Melbourne, and I'm in Sydney. So it's, technology is a absolutely incredible thing when you can flip files around like pancakes, you know, and have massive, ginormous files sent to the other side of the world in 30 seconds.
And just think, when these lyrics were written, none of that was even conceivable, you know?
No. So we're really, you know, I think we're really lucky to have this technology that we've got now, because it's been done really quickly. The production of this has been really quick, but it's been 100% everybody all in, you know what I mean? Like, everybody's been giving their all, and we've had the technology, we've had each other's, you know, we've formed a nice little group of people. There's Malcolm Holmes from Talking Elephant, mm-hmm. who is bringing out the album on that label. We've got Sean Phillips from the Brasenose. She's a stage manager. And Ben Wild, who's also manager of the Brasenose. They've taken us on with accommodation and hosting the album and the exhibition. I haven't said anything about that yet in this conversation.
We'll get to that, don't you worry.
Yeah. So the album's going to come out. It's the release is on the 10th of August at the Brasenose, and Carla's going to be performing there all the songs from the album and probably a few original Sandys. Yeah, I'm really looking forward to it. Really am. It's
going to be. You're at a slight advantage as we speak, because all I've heard at the moment is the actual song, the original Carla Fuchs song called Songbird. I haven't heard the actual rest of the album.
Oh, the rest. Yeah, yeah. Okay, so we just wanted to give a teaser. We didn't really want to give anything away yet in the fact that it's really special. It's really, really good. I've listened to all the demos from when she started sending demos, and they were just so good. And she doesn't think they're good now, but I still love them. I think they're amazing. Now she's actually mixing them down in the studio. Right now we've got a deadline. It's about to happen. It's all about to happen. And I've listened to a few of the final tracks, and they are just so good. I'm really, really pleased with how she's worked and the outcome of everything. Yeah, incredible, incredible.
Just going by the song titles, one of them's about you, is it not?
Oh, yes, Georgia. So that is a poem that my mum wrote, obviously, to me. It is so beautiful, and the song, every time I hear it, I nearly burst into tears because it's just so, it's so lovely, and she's just done such a perfect job of, you know, the melody and everything that goes with it. She's, yeah, it's...
It works.
It's a special one. It's a special one. And, yeah, the other songs, there's a few more that... All of them are amazing. I can't pick anything bad in any of them. So I really can't wait for everyone to hear them.
Sing to me from the depths. be taught. Traveling south, flying by your side. These winter days, I got George on my mind. Friendship and light guided by your wings. Beautiful guardian angel who sings. Look closely for her. Hold her to heart. Always be near and never too far. Hello, songbird, sing to me. Your royal evocation, silence is yours. God-given gift, the most beautiful sound. With effortless wings, fly too close to the ground. Song, it is yours, but the change is mine, and we are all united in the secret of time.
The other thing which I've noticed you've said, and which I noticed as well, it's interesting how Carla is performing, you know, your mum's lyrics to her own music, but she's not trying to sound like Sandy Denny. She's still sounding like herself, which is the best way to do it, I would have thought.
Yeah, she's she has. I don't even know how to explain how she does it because I'm not a musician myself, but. All I know is when your hair stands up on your arms, it's mm-hmm. good music. And she's renowned for that with me anyway. I'm probably her biggest fan. I just love her stuff. Love it. And she's got totally different stuff as well. Like it's not – this is a style, I guess, that's Denny Fuchs – do you know what I mean? It's both of them together and it's just created this really unique sound that's it's not like Sandy, it's not like Carla, it's both of them together and it's really beautiful. This is a real treat for everyone, I think. It's been a while since anything was like it's been a while since anything new has surfaced. So
indeed.
We're hoping that this will be we're hoping this will be good for everybody and everyone will love it. I mean, I'm sure they will, but you know, you've always got that nail biting feeling sometimes like whoa.
Yeah,
what are people going to think? But, yeah, no, it's amazing. If you like Songbird, the rest of it's just incredible.
Now, you mentioned before that you're not a musician. You did actually, just as a by the by, you did actually have a musical career of your own there for a while, did you not?
Yeah, I've been a DJ since I was 16.
Is that still happening?
At the moment, since I've been doing this project, I've had to cancel a few gigs because I've just been so engrossed in the artwork and the production of this whole thing. But the DJing has been a big part of my life as well. Playing here in Sydney and Melbourne, I've produced a couple of tracks as well. They never went anywhere. I actually did a remix of a couple of my mum's songs. And I know that some people would probably not agree with putting my mum into techno music, but it doesn't sound bad. It was done a while ago now. The DJing's been my life. I never listened to folk music before I got into this whole thing, and that's another story that we might chat about as well if you want.
Interesting. Mm. This is ringing a bell when you're saying you worked on a couple of your mum's songs. I'm sure back in the day when it came out, I'm sure I played one of them, but I can't remember which songs were they.
The Quiet Joys of Brotherhood and She Moves Through the Fair.
Mm. I'm sure I've played one of them on air before, a long time ago, but I'm sure.
Oh, really? Okay, so yeah, they're on SoundCloud, and my DJ name is Basscat, Basscatt, and or it's Unleashed Beats, and that's my SoundCloud page, and you can listen to all my music there.
So you have a couple of daughters yourself, and they're getting into music in their own way as well, are they not? Is that still happening?
Yes. Jamira and Ariel, they're 25 now, they're twins. They're very talented young ladies. Jamira has actually performed a couple of times at warming up for Wayne Gillespie at a couple of Sydney clubs. My dad produced Wayne's first album. I can't remember what it's called now. It's really bad.
New Locations comes to mind.
Yes, you got it. That's the one. So Wayne has been a close friend of the family since my dad died, and he's taken Jamira under his wing a couple of times, and she's performed before his sets, and she's just amazing. When she plays her own music, Jamira, she's really incredible. She's probably going to be working on an album with Wayne Gillespie towards the end of this year. So that'll be interesting, and can't wait to you know, work on that with her. Ariel plays the guitar. She hasn't gotten out as much as Jamira, but they're both really unique. They don't sound like my mum, but they've still got the gene, and they can play guitar, and they both sing. So, you know, they're both into their fitness a lot at the moment, both personal trainers, both do jiu-jitsu. Yeah.
In the same sense that the album, which we're mainly talking about, Songbird, has the Sandy element to it, obviously, but doesn't sound like it's probably good that your daughters, you know, clearly there'd be some lineage there, some musical lineage, but it's good that they're not trying to sound like their grandmother either.
Yeah, it's good. Sandy stands in a league of her own. She's there's no one like her, really, which is amazing to have that. I mean, I never knew her, but to have this whole legacy and to have all of her music still and the love for her, it's really, truly incredible.
It is. Now, you mentioned your dad, that being Trevor Lucas. As you say, you wouldn't have known your mum because you were very young when she decided to leave us. Your dad lasted in this world a bit longer than that, 1989. So do you have any sort of, did he encourage you to be involved with music? Do you have any particularly fond memories from, you know, from so long ago with him?
Yeah, a lot. My dad was my best friend. He took me horse riding. I did horse riding lessons, did tennis. He took me to piano lessons, which didn't go so well. Unfortunately, he died when I was 10, so that sort of all went away. After that, it was a bit depressing. But I did, I think when my dad died, it was like, I didn't really want to know about music anymore. I sort of went to the techno. It was sort of like mind numbing and like, but I got into that. It was good as well. So just didn't really listen to live music anymore. And yeah.
That didn't last too long, I assume.
What
or
do you
did
mean?
It? Not wanting to be involved in music directly.
Yeah, no, I got into the dance music and started DJing and sort of kept in that scene. Didn't really listen to any live or, you know, singer-songwriter stuff. I just didn't really want to listen to sad stuff. Couldn't understand why people wanted to cry and listen to music.
Do you understand that now, I wonder?
Yes, I do, definitely. Look, when I got breast cancer in 2018, and then is when I had a full flip of my life and stopped everything that I was doing that was bad and tried to tackle the cancer thing, and it's been many years now since then. I've had 7 operations, and now I am a holistic, organic. My whole house is a medicine cabinet, basically. I've just made a tea for myself, and my tea has got clove, wormwood, and what else has it got? I'm just pouring it right now. Clove, wormwood, mint, and what are those little cardamom pods in it? Mm-hmm. So, yeah, it doesn't sound that nice, but it is really nice.
No sugar or anything?
No sugar. I don't do dairy. I don't do meat. I only do organic, and I try and keep my family as healthy as I can. When all of this started, I decided that I'd better sort of acknowledge my mum and my dad's legacy and stop pushing it away. So that's when I sort of did a crash course in my own crash course in folk music and my mum and everything. So I wouldn't, because I thought I was going to die. I thought, oh, the cancer's going to get me. That's it. You know, when you first get told that you've got cancer, it's just, you don't know anything about any of it. You don't know how to look after yourself. You don't know. It's the big C. So it's like, whoa. But I, 7 years of learning and mistakes and learning and mistakes, I've gotten to this point where I am talking to you right now. So I'm pretty happy.
Are you happy to say, or are you able to say that it's under control and it's manageable, or what's the situation at the moment, if I may ask?
The situation is that my oncologist didn't want to see me for a whole year. It has nearly been 6 months, so I will see him. I feel good within myself. I'm so healthy, and I'm so I'm really, really strict on myself, really strict, and I think I've got to be, because it is a horrible disease, and it can really knock people if they don't grab it before it grabs them.
Indeed.
A dear family friend of ours here in Sydney, he got cancer and he just let go, just let it take him. And he just didn't want to try. And it's really sad, because some people just don't have it in them. I tried to help, but, you know, sometimes you can only help yourself. And when you find out, sometimes you need to be shaken to learn. And I was one of those people that needed shaking and slapping in the sense that, hey, you've got cancer, wake the F up.
Well, good on you for not giving in and for still being with us now, which is a testament to a strong will, I would say. A strong will.
Yeah. Well, when I was born, I was very preemie, and from then I think I've been fighting. So I've been fighting my whole life. So I'm really grateful that I'm here and talking to you, and I never thought in my wildest dreams that I'd be doing something like this right now.
Yeah, cool. And yet, here you are.
Yeah.
Here you are.
Yep. Pretty cool.
You mentioned before that you're going to be in the UK soon for the launch of the album, but there's also, I do believe, an exhibition that you're putting on of, what is it, mostly memorabilia to do with your mum? Is it like really rare stuff that people wouldn't have seen before and that sort of thing?
Yeah, well, it's all come out of the archives in the UK. It's, and most of the jewelry and the clothing have been with me for the last, I don't know, 10, 15 years, and I didn't know what to do with any of it. And I thought before COVID I was going to do what I'm doing now at the cricket club, I think it was, at Cropredy during the festival, just before COVID hit, but that just destroyed everything. So here I am now doing it. I've got dresses, I've got her Gibson, I've got all her diaries, loads of photos, just some beautiful, beautiful pieces of jewellery and some of her jewellery boxes and just beautiful stuff, really, really nice. Her awards. And I can't wait to share it with everybody because it's just been sitting in boxes here, like nobody can see it. No one can experience it and love it. So I thought I'd just bring it to where everybody's going to be, that everybody loves my mum, and that's what I'm doing, bringing it out.
Diaries, did you say?
Yes, yes. So this is where all the lyrics came from, the lost lyrics, and this is diving into my mum's head. The album booklet is made up of all my mum's little doodles and sketches, and from the songbooks, all the lyrics.
Wow.
I'm a graphic designer, so I have done the whole album myself with Sean Phillips, who's helped me set it in design. That in itself is beautiful. As beautiful as the album. I know we've just gone back off topic, but I forgot to mention that I had done all the artwork, and there's some special artwork that I'd done because I'm an artist as well. So, yeah, it's
a whole package.
It's a whole package. I'll be selling some of my original Sandy sketches and some other artwork and memorabilia, merchandise and stuff like that. And it'll be for 3 days at the Brasenose. I really can't wait. It's 19 days to go.
Wow. Now, for those who can't make it, which might be some people, is there any other way to see the exhibition or what's in the exhibition, or is it pretty much there? In other words, are you going to take it anywhere else?
We are doing a A4 landscape exhibition booklet with all the items. Well, not all of them, but most of the items will be in the booklet, and we will be selling them on at the festival. But I'm sure I could there's going to be more to sell online.
Mm-hmm.
And you never know, this is just the beginning. I don't know, maybe the exhibition will, you know, be somewhere else. Maybe I'll take it to Sydney somewhere, or I don't know what's going to happen next. I've never done anything like this before, so yeah, we'll just take it one step at a time. It's all packed in suitcases right now. It's like 40 kilos of my mum's stuff.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so it's pretty exciting, really, really excited to share it with everyone, finally. I'm also bringing two plaques for the Jonah tree on the field at Cropredy. For my mum and dad, Ed Frost is going to be, we're going to be writing little message on the plaques. And the Jonah tree is a tree at Cropredy that people put their loved ones' plaques, memories on this tree. And I think my dad and mum deserve to be up there, so I'll be doing that also.
Are they not there already?
No.
That's a little bit remiss, I'd have thought.
Yeah, so I'm really glad that I'm the one that's going to be presenting this to the tree and with Fairport Convention on one of the days, probably on the Sunday.
So that's the exhibition. Mm. But the main thing we're talking about is, stroke has been, the Carla Fuchs album Songbird, which will be out before you know it, but not just yet. This might be a totally unanswerable question, but I'll try it anyway. Your mum's music, what do you think it is, or what do you think it might be about Sandy Denny's music that is still attracting and indeed influencing people, so many people today, which is, you know, several decades after she left us? What is it about the music or about her, do you think?
I think that she was just such a misunderstood woman, and she was so just like innocent and so real, and she poured everything out in her songs. And when you hear some of those recordings, it's like nothing you've ever heard before. It's like it takes your breath away, and it will always sound like that every time you play whatever song resonates with you, because they're all so good. Everybody has their own favorite Sandy Denny song. But then everyone's got so many favorites. I don't think you can put your finger on your favorite. Sometimes you've got one that you play more than another one. I've got them all going through my head right now. Music Weaver, like, absolutely insanely beautiful. I don't know. I'm gobsmacked right now just trying to think about, you know, all the songs. The Lady, Who Knows Where the Time Goes. That's, yeah, everybody's favourite. And it just, she wrote that when she was so young. And it's like, she was an old soul. She knew stuff. And she wrote it in her songs.
And you're proud as hell of her, aren't you?
Oh, you have no idea. You have no idea. It's a bit surreal sometimes to think that that's my mum and that she's I never met her and that's my mum. It's like I still spin out about it.
And, yeah. You know, despite all of that, you're the one that's helping to keep her name alive, especially with this Songbird album. And especially with the exhibitions and everything else that you've done, you're the one. I mean, I can't imagine her not being proud of you.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, no, I'm proud of her. I'm proud to be her daughter, and it's my calling. This is what I'm meant to be doing. This is how I'm meant to be, you know, keeping her flame alight. This is it. I'm doing it. This is what it means to be alive, you know.
Like me, I can't afford to live in this place, and I can't afford to leave. My friends all say it's a rotten shame, and I just can't understand why. Push me around on a wild goose chase, by land or sea or sky. And if I don't make it before I die, I just ain't gonna die. Sixpence in another chance to seek the sixpence in the pie. If I don't find it before I die, I just ain't gonna die. Just ain't gonna die.